just what are these glowing orbs that everyone is making a fuss over? They're absolutely beautiful. They seem to grow randomly throughout the valley. I know nothing about them other than that they are indigenous to this valley and that the army is using their energy for their war project. That's about as much as they'll tell me. It's such a shame. I wish they would just let them be. But I suppose it's the whole reason we're here to begin with.
Thank you.
clear to me that the natives of the valley worshipped the giant tree here almost as a deity. Great lengths were taken to construct obelisks around this tree, which the ancients used to help grow it. I've begun to use the term Titan tree to designate it. According to my interpretation, once every 1,000 years, the Titan tree will produce the myth. And famed Lifeseed, said to possess the power to shatter the world into fragments. No wonder the military is so interested in this place. playful little sprites of this valley, which I've come to call daemons, are so lively. I've done my best to study their behaviors, but without a zoologist on site, I'm mostly coming up dry. They're completely harmless, so the army tends to ignore them as they go about their research. I wonder if the world would clamor to have these daemons as pets. I'm sure my mother could use one. Better than all those feral cats in her backyard, anyways.
Thank you.
According to legend, the Lifeseed is said to be a bringer of death on a global scale, splintering the Earth into fragments. Such end-time scenarios are common across mythologies, from the apocalypse to Ragnarok. However, it's unusual for the event to surround a particular object, especially one acquired by mortals.
Thank you.
origin of this valley's inhabitants continues to elude me. They seem to have coexisted with the mysterious forest sprites. I find loose hints of Mesoamerican civilizations, such as the Olmec, with their renowned colossal headstone sculptures dating back to 900 BC. Strangely, though, the Olmec civilization was much younger and located no less than 5,000 kilometers away from here.
Thanks. Join the fun and make a geeky gamer happy with the follow.
Thanks.
civilization take hold so far north. The land here isn't arable, yet the population that lived here was clearly sedentary in nature. This leads me to believe this place was used as a sacred ground. Are these monuments to the mythical cannibal giants of native lore? The Saiteka?
Fisher, lead physicist, beginning Pathfinder testing on the Icarus boost upgrade. The secondary boost augmentation to the leaf suit should allow a Pathfinder to jump twice in sequence through the air, increasing the height and distance of their leap drastically. Report any defects to a commanding officer immediately.
How rarely a Lifeseed is produced. I was so excited when I discovered there was one found in the valley. Apparently the military was just as excited as they immediately confiscated it to study at the Soma facility on the mountaintop. They won't let me anywhere near it.
Thanks. Thank you.
One thing I could do without in this valley, it's those damn Amrita swarms that seem to infect this place. They aren't so bad when they're calm, but when they're starved of Amrita energy, they become incredibly aggressive, sending waves of drones toward intruders in suicidal attacks. They seem to be becoming angrier the longer we're here.
Thank you.
From what I've been told, Cesuris was discovered back in 1811 by a surveyor seeking to map this remote region. No one believed what he reportedly saw. Due to the sheer remoteness of this region, his story was written off as the senile delusions of an old man, and his tale was soon forgotten. It was not until recently that the government was approached by a scientist named Andrew Fisher to use this location as an alternative energy project of some sort. How he came to discover this place is beyond me.
Thank you.
Join the fun and make a geeky gamer happy with the follow. Thank you.